Doklam is an area which is divided into two parts. There's a North Doklam and a South Doklam. There's a nala which runs through, which is called the Torsa Nala. Torsa Nala separates North Doklam from South Doklam. In the South Doklam is a ridge called Jamfeli Ridge, where the RBA has a seasonal post. The Royal Bhutan Army maintains a seasonal post on South Doklam at the Jamfeli Ridge, which is the southern extremity of Doklam. Now, as far as the Northern Doklam is concerned, there are three passes there. Now, through these passes, the Chinese had been building a road, and the road construction had been going on since 2000 and a little before that also. And they had gradually started building a road in this area through a pass called Batangla, and this road was coming in, and they kept coming in till the year 2016, about June 16, they had come in fairly close to our area, and they were quite close to the area called Torsa Nala, and they would come build a road and go back, and they kept doing this. So there was a road, but it was a dirt track, because that territory is not very difficult. On its own side, coming up to Batangla or a Merugla, the other pass, it is the road is difficult, it's coming onto a hill. But when he comes down the hill, it is like a dirt track, that road construction is not very difficult. So he had been building this road, and he would come and go back. And the Bhutanese were patrolling this area, and we were watching all this activity from our side, and the Bhutanese go and patrol. But this is territory actually which is disputed between Bhutan and China. China claims that the Doklam area is his, and Bhutan claims it is theirs, that up to the pass it is theirs. So it is really their territory. Now what happened was, one fine day we found in last year, they came with fairly large amount of equipment, large amount of people supported by PLA. And they then again, whatever they had left the road in June 16, up to June 16 it would be very inconspicuous activity, one or two bulldozers coming, just come and scrap the earth and go away. But this time we found that the kind of equipment and manpower that they had come with, they meant business. And we felt that they would probably try and claim the whole of Doklam and build a road there, and possibly reach where the RBA post was. That was our impression we had. So we realized that if this is going to happen, then we may have to block them, because it was also posing a threat to us. It was changing a status quo. With Chinese, we also have an arrangement of not changing status quo. That, wherever we are, we should maintain peace and tranquility. We must inform the other side and whatever activity we are doing. So here we felt it was a change in status quo. And so when this change of status quo was happening, and we felt that he could take the road further down south, is when we were compelled to take action, and we blocked him. And that is where it led to a stalemate, and this stalemate continued. Now, as far as the Northern Doklam part is concerned, as I said, the PLA has occupied that area. They are there. Because when the disengagement took place, the disengagement was that, this was whatever we were doing during the Doklam crisis, let me tell you that we had excellent coordination between the government. In fact, I dare say between the PMO, the Ministry of External Affairs, the Ministry of Defense, and the Army. We were having regular meetings, and all action that we were taken was, I would say, a well-coordinated action. But that time what we had decided was that so that we don't create too much of confusion, the spokesperson will be the MEA spokesperson. So whatever discussion we would have, and how we had to project this, and how we had to approach the Chinese, or how we had to approach the media, would be that the MEA would take the lead in this. And that is why you found that time to time the MEA would come out with statements that were there. Because the issue was that we had actually stepped into a territory which wasn't ours. It was a different issue. And when you step into a different territory which is not yours, the MEA comes into play. It is not that you had stepped into your territory. You had stepped into a territory which either belonged to China or belonged to Bhutan. It didn't belong to us. So here and after, what's happened, the Chinese have stayed put in that area. Now when the Chinese stayed put in the area, we came for a disengagement. The disengagement said, okay, we should not have a face-to-face confrontation, because here we were face-to-face. So we said we should separate out. So that separation has taken place. we have come back from where we had stepped in into our own territory. We are now on the watershed, and the Chinese have gone back that much distance. But behind that, they have continued to maintain themselves. Now, when the escalation had taken place and this kind of a situation had happened, a large number of troops we had also seen in other areas of Tibet. You know, we have seen large number of troops in other areas, including some guns, some tanks and other equipment. But let me tell you, we have seen that complete equipment almost gone. That equipment is gone. But as far as the North Dolom area is concerned, which I said where the Chinese had come and the disengagement taking place, the Chinese are there. But there too, thinning out has happened. What we had worked out on the disengagement, that we'll only separate out and keep this separation between us. Even behind that, while there are large number of tents that can be seen in that area, large amount of troops have actually gone back from that area also. We are not seeing the kind of activity that we were seeing there in the months of July, June, July and August. That kind of activity is not visible in that area. Though the tents remain, he's got his, you know, he had constructed some toilets, those toilets remain, he had created some, you know, observation posts from he could very good observe those areas, those structures remain. But we are seeing a reduction in manpower that has happened. So as of now, what we feel is that this de-escalation has happened due to the winter months maybe, or because he felt that it has time has come to de-escalate. But because the structures are still there, which are temporary structures, a lot of it is temporary structures, there is a possibility of movement again taking place once the winter months get over. It could happen here, it could happen elsewhere. And that is what we are saying, so we are prepared. So should he come in again, we will again take a call on what has to be done. But let me tell you, diplomatic efforts are on to de-escalate everything and see that everything returns to normalcy. It is now more important is the engagement between Bhutan and China as to how they resolve the issue. So the issue is to say that there is a border demarcation talks also happening between Bhutan and China, and how they progress is we'll have to wait and watch, because our own border demarcation is also yet to take place. In fact, we haven't had our own border demarcation, and so has Bhutan not carried out the border demarcation. So you know, all that will happen, we'll have to wait and watch, but talks are going on. So that is as far as situation. Yes, he is there in Doklam, but we have seen reduction in strength. Tents remain, lot of empty tents are there, lot of empty toilet structures are there. Then he's created some storage shelters, you know, where he had brought some cots and all for his people, for his soldiers who are staying there. He's brought some cots, so we can see those structures there. Some of those cots have not even been assembled. They are lying the way they are, you know, because he possibly thought that if he has to stay there for a longer duration or keep larger troops, he was prepared for that, but he has thinned out from that area. Well, all effort was being made by us to ensure that it does not lead to a conflict. But that does not mean that you do not prepare for it. So we were taking all actions in a graduated manner without raising heckles to ensure that should it escalate, firstly try and keep it confined to that particular sector. And in this particular sector, let me tell you, we were at a tremendous advantage. The terrain favored us. Everything else favored us. So maybe was that leading to some kind of overconfidence in our minds, in the local formation commanders, maybe. And therefore, you know, was it that could have led to belligerence? It could have. But then all effort we were trying to make sure that we try and resolve this issue peacefully. It was one incident which had happened where road construction has been going on in a number of places where the PLA has constructed roads, we have constructed roads. It is a perception because the PLA had come there earlier also, till 2016 also they were building roads, we hadn't stopped them. So you know, we were concerned about that, but let us say if it could have escalated, we were prepared. Not that things would have gone down, but in this particular sector, terrain favors us. Let me also tell you, on the northern borders, ladies and gentlemen, terrain hugely favors us. You know, don't see what happened in 62. We are now sitting on the borders. Everywhere we are practically on the border, except for some sectors where even in his case the situation is difficult. Otherwise, we are sitting on the borders now. We are manning the borders round the clock. We have good surveillance means now available to monitor the activity that is happening. So it is not that it's going to be easy. He may fight the war differently. As I said, we are more concerned not about fighting the borders on the northern borders. We are more concerned about cyber and IW. I mean, that is the focus where we have to be focused on, whether he will start with cyber. And whether when you find that your bank account, suddenly you find money, you know, getting whisked away from your bank accounts, whether war has started or not, or whether we will understand that. So that is what we are, our own networks failing. That is where we are trying to ensure that we have to have now good firewalls in place. We have to harden our system to ensure that we are capable of handling that, because it may well start that way.